As Americans, we probably know more about World War II than any other war in our history. We've listened to the speeches. We've watched the movies. We've heard stories from the soldiers who risked their lives to defend the freedom of countries thousands of miles away. We may have heard of D-Day, but we have not heard the stories of the men, women, and children liberated from enemy forces that day. For the citizens of Normandy, D-Day is more than a date in a history book or archival footage on a movie screen. D-Day means liberation. D-Day is freedom.
My name is Daniel Patricks. 1 year after being liberated from German control, I found myself standing in a ceremony on Utah Beach, wearing a new dress sewn by my mother Cecile. It was made from parachutes of the soldiers who fought valiantly to liberate me, my family, my neighbors and all of France from Hitler's terrible grasp.
Memories of war and liberation have been passed down from one generation to the next to thank and honor their liberators.
Les cimetières, il y a eu tant de morts pour, hein, pour sauver la France et tous les pays qui étaient occupés par l'Allemagne. Où qu'on serait aujourd'hui, nous Français, si vous les Américains, vous n'étiez pas venus.
That some boys and in some cases kids went ashore on our beaches to fight in a hell, to liberate people they even didn't know. And when you realize it, and you realize that you are free, that you can use your language, continue to maintain your traditions, then you realize what they have done and the sacrifice that many of them have made.
Moi, quand ils sont arrivés, ils avaient 20 ans et moi j'avais 10 ans. Et c'était des super héros. Et quand ils revenaient, mon plaisir c'était de les accompagner, de les aider, de les écouter.
For survivors, we can welcome them, escort them to ceremonies, or visiting them in the U.S. when it's possible, and take care of them and cherish them. This is the only thing I can do, which is nothing in comparison to what they have done for us.
In Normandy, celebrations of remembrance and gratitude take place every year. French citizens bring World War II veterans and their families to Normandy to share their stories. In doing so, the French, once liberated by the Americans, liberate these soldiers in return from their oppressive memories of war.
Freedom is not free. It's too important to never forget.
We have to keep the memory alive because it can always come back if we forget. The Americans, they are our liberator, you know. We have to thank them forever, really.
The Girl Who Wore Freedom is an unconventional love story that began between the people of Normandy and the American GIs who freed them from German occupation and continues today. A story told from the perspective and memories of those who lived it, memories of hardship, death, heroism, and love.
These are our stories, Normandy's stories.